So how's your day going? And hi Ranjita, I guess this is your first class, right? Yeah, no problem. Great. So yeah, we are just starting to Ranjita. I mean, you can see the previous class. No, you can't speak actually. I mean, you don't need that. All you can do is only two things: type and watch the screen. That's it. So you can't really talk unless and until I give the permissions, and I don't want to give that permission because that will eat the bandwidth of everybody. Okay? Great. So yeah guys, how's your day going on? They just started, I know, but still, some hours has been gone by, so. Okay. Great. So, you guys know anything about HTML? A bit. Okay. Okay, XML file, but XML is different from HTML. So, like XML is all about the custom tags which you define, but in HTML it's all predefined tags, so and that's a bit different. Okay, yeah, fine. No issues in that. You don't have to, have anything, any previous knowledge for learning HTML. So that's the beauty of HTML. So all you gotta do is like just concentrate on what I'm teaching there, and the kind of assignments I'm giving. So that's the only thing. So you'll be learning HTML in 5 days. So that I can guarantee if you follow up my classes. Okay. So yeah, today's class, the concentration is on learning about HTML. So what is HTML? So I'll just give an overview of what we're gonna learn. So I'll just say what is HTML. Okay. I'm not talking about the history of HTML because that doesn't really help us in learning HTML. So. But if you are curious, you can Google Wikipedia for HTML. Okay, so that there you will be knowing about the history of HTML, and we will see our first program. Okay, I don't call it as program, I'll call it as pages. So HTML is not a programming language, it is just a I say there's no logic involved in it, so that's why I don't call it as a program. So it's just a plain text file with tags and a .html extension. Okay, so that's what we're gonna see in today's class. Okay, so the tags you'll be learning here is HTML tag, head tag, and a title tag and a body tag, and we have some header tags and p tag, okay, and img tag. Okay, so this is an overview. Don't worry if you don't know about these things because you'll be learning this in today's class. All right, so now the first of our discussion is what is HTML. So anybody know what is HTML? Can somebody give the what do you call it, abbreviation of HTML here? Yes, and then you can try out, no problem, no issues in that. Even if you go wrong, no problems in it. Yes, anyone here? No? Okay, fine. So I'll go ahead here and just give the abbreviation of it. It's a hyper text markup language. Okay, hyper text markup language. So you might have heard about this, like hyper text markup language. Maybe that did not strike your brain, but yeah. So I'm gonna just divide the definitions here. So the first here is hypertext, and the next is markup. And again, language, you all guys know, you know what exactly the essence of a language. Language is just to communicate or interpret. Like I'm speaking now English, so you guys can understand it. If somebody don't understand English, they may use the translator. So like such, you know, language is a communication medium wherein people understand what I'm really trying to say or convey. Okay, so we forgot about language here. Just I'll call it as a medium to communicate. Okay, in general. So coming to the hypertext here. So you guys know about internet, right? Right, internet. So what is internet? Again, internet is nothing but a connection between different computers. Okay, so wherein we you can fetch information. Now as of now, you know, you guys can attend this class using internet. That means your computer and my computer are hooked up so that you guys can see whatever, you know, I'm telling here, and you guys can chat here with me just because of the internet. So internet is connecting, right? Am I right? Internet is just connecting wherein we transfer data. So just a layman language. So there's a big definition for it, but I'm just using some layman language to make you guys understand what exactly internet is. This is where we transfer data across computers. So nowadays it's mobiles too, right? And internet has come down to the mobiles and tablets. So nowadays it's computers and mobiles. So here, what really happens on internet is, okay, you see this www.tutorslang.com. So you open a browser, right? You open a browser, your favorite browser, maybe Chrome, Firefox, Safari. So, and very few use Internet Explorer. Okay, so you open your browser and you just type www.tutorslive.com, right? It will open, okay, Tutors Live homepage or the landing page. I call it as landing page. So landing page is that page which is seen as soon as somebody hits a URL. So it's called landing page in, you know, web development terms, web development and web design terms. Okay, so that's there. So now here, now there are certain tabs on. So let me just share my screen here to show you guys what happens over there. So you know, I share my screen here. Just let me know if anybody is not able to see my screen. Okay, so can you guys see my screen here? Yes? So here it is. Can you guys see it? Yes or no? Can you guys hear me actually? Yeah, can you guys see my screen? Fantastic. Oh, you see a blank screen, not the Google. Okay, great. So yeah, it's maybe because of the connection here. You can check the connection speed here, like, you know, what's really happening over there. So the latency is 44 milliseconds. This is like, you know, you can see, you know, the content which is 44 milliseconds late. That's what you know, that's it's called. Okay, no issues in that, don't worry. The video will be recorded. Yeah, don't worry about it. So the video will be recorded and put on YouTube, so you guys to not to miss any update. Okay, just subscribe to us on YouTube. Okay, this is our URL for YouTube. Okay, so here you can get any update regarding the videos, or else alternatively you can go here and add us to your circles on Google Plus. So you go here, you can add us, and you can see the updates again. Okay, and we have a Facebook group too. I told this again in the previous class. So that's groups/tutorslive. So go there, join the group for, you know, very good updates over there, because I feel Facebook is a good medium to exchange our ideas and programming language. Okay, so that's where that's all, I suppose. You know, guys can have this knowledge. That's enough. Okay, fine. So let me just do this here. www.tudoslive.com. Now, if you want to go out of this page, let's say if you want to go out of this page to a new page inside Tudor's Live, okay? So what I'm supposed to do here, I click on students, it took me to a different page, right? I click on tutors, it takes me a different page, right? I click on contact, it took me a different page, and here, coming to the bottom here, okay, I click on Facebook here, Facebook icon, it took me to a different page, right? Yes. So this is the hypertext. So what I'm doing on a single page, on a single tudoslive.com page, okay, I'm using links. These are called links, links to different pages or links to different websites, links to different, you know, different other things, right? So these are all links. So these links, which are used to navigate from one page to other page, okay, is called hypertext. Yes, you guys here? I hope you guys are following this. So what I'm trying to say here, hypertext is nothing but linking between different URLs. So URLs is universal resource locator. That means, you know, where the you know, the address www.tudorslive.com is a URL. Okay, so it's linking between different URLs. So that's the hypertext. And coming to the markup, so this is what, you know, the entire HTML is. Markup is nothing but tags, tags and content using together. When you use tags and content together, that's called a web page. When you use tags and content, that becomes a web page. And to write that tags and content is called markup. So if you write tags and content, it's called markup. Okay, so it's specific tags and content. Okay, so using tags and content, you link different URLs. Okay, and you have to communicate that to your browser, right? So your browser is a software. Oops. Okay, it's gone actually. My bad. My hypertext is linking different URLs. Okay, markup is nothing but tags and content. Okay, and coming to the language here, so I'm just defining what language exactly. So you have this browser is nothing but a software. Browser is a software. Okay, so it must understand HTML, right? To show something on the web page, okay, it must understand HTML. So in that sense only it can show something on it. Okay, so what browser does is browser interprets the HTML tags. So browser interprets HTML tags, okay, and shows the content. So you see again, it's a markup, right? Tags and content is markup. So browser interprets the markup and it will show the content. So every tag in HTML has a formatting or meaning. Okay, that is the reason we need tags, you know, to show something. To show an image on the browser, we need a tag, because I can't really put an image over there. To show a link, I need a tag. To show a table, to show a form, you see these contact us forms, these fancy contact us forms, they are made using HTML. Okay, you see these tables on browsers, they are made of using, you know, HTML tags. And you see these images on the browsers, they are done using HTML tags. Okay, so that's about the tags, you know, what exactly HTML is. Why do we need HTML? We need HTML to show our web pages, okay, to the internet world. So that's where the browser Okay, yeah, no problem. Okay, so yeah, why do we need HTML? We need HTML to put whatever I want to do on my web page. Okay, I put it in terms of markup, okay, and put it on a server. Okay, I'll talk about servers and that stuff later because we don't really need a server now. So that's why I'm not talking about servers. So you know, we put the content somewhere on the internet, and if somebody pings that particular URL, okay, like www.tutoslave.com, so show me that particular, you know, HTML page. Okay, so that's why we need HTML. HTML is the face of your content. So to show your content to a particular user on the internet who hits your URL, we need HTML. And this is what HTML does. This is what the meaning of HTML. So any questions here, guys? I can answer your questions. Yes? Any questions here? So I can move forward if you don't have any questions here. Great. That's fantastic. So what do you need now? I'm saying that HTML is a markup, right? And I'm saying HTML is a language. So what you need? You need a notepad. That is it. You just need a notepad to write your HTML code. So what software you need to write? So we usually call it as editor. Okay, you can use editors. So for instance, editors for Windows, okay, Windows it's Notepad, and for Unix or Linux, it's called Gedit, or you know, the VI editor, whatever you call it as. And for again, for Safari, the same, I guess. I don't exactly remember the name of the editor over there. Maybe Gedit itself. Okay, so yeah, all you need is Notepad for writing basic code of HTML. But if you want to, there are some fancy editors out there which can help you in, you know, in differentiating the tags and content. Okay, so for that purpose, I use Notepad++ for Windows, and Sublime Editor is one very good editor for the same purpose. Okay, so I'm using a Windows machine here, so that's the reason I'm only recommending, you know, the softwares or the editors for Windows. Okay, so Notepad++ and Sublime Editor, and you can also use NetBeans, but I don't really prefer this. Okay, so these are for heavy coding of, I mean, this is for PHP actually. Okay, and some people use Dreamweaver, Adobe Dreamweaver. Again, this is for hardcore designers, I say. So, but you know, for people like us who are, you know, developers, more of developers than designers. Okay, so I prefer Notepad++ to start with. Start with Notepad++. It's free to download. Okay, this is free to download. You can just Google it, Notepad++. Okay, or even this is free to download. So when we move to you know, what you call CSS, okay, there's an extension to the HTML program. When we move to CSS, I'll show about the Sublime Editor. Why Sublime Editor? Sublime Text actually. This is Sublime Text. Why Sublime Text is more popular for, you know, HTML and CSS than Notepad++. Okay, I'll be explaining that differentiation later. But to start off with, okay, I really suggest go with the Notepad++. All right. And what else you need? You need a browser. You need a browser. So any browser, I prefer Chrome. Okay, Chrome is more developer friendly. So, or else you can also go with Firefox. Okay, so to test your web pages, you can also install Internet Explorer, Safari, Opera. You know, there are a lot of browsers out there. You can really, you know, if you want to test. So I make them as optional. You don't really need this, but if you want to really test your web pages across all the browsers, how is it, you know, looking up, or you know, because different browsers render HTML differently. They understand HTML differently. Now that's a drawback of the HTML standard. There is no proper standard for HTML code. So, but the most prominent and popular ones are Chrome and Firefox. So these two work together actually. Like, you don't have to worry about how my HTML will look up on Chrome and Firefox. You don't have to really worry about it. Right? So that's you need. And one last thing you need is that when you save your file, save it with .html extension. That is it. You're done. Okay, so what do you need? You need an editor here. So editor, any editor. So I'll use Notepad++ for today, and I'll show Sublime Text when we move to CSS, okay, not in HTML. And we need a browser here, so I'll be using Chrome here. The browser I use is Chrome. And when you save your file, remember to save it with .html extension. All right? Any questions here regarding anything? You can just shoot any question. Don't worry, don't hesitate. Okay, regarding the tool, I explain this again. So if you want to talk only with me, let's say if you feel your question is really silly, or if you feel like your question is really complex, okay, you can also, you know, talk to me by selecting the drop down. You see that two over there, select it, select my name and send the message. Nobody else can see that message except me. Okay, so do not hesitate to post any question. So if you do not post any question, you are just beating the purpose of Tutos Live. Tutos Live is only for one-to-one communication. It's just like a classroom communication. You know, that's what I really wanted from my students too. Okay, so any questions here, don't hesitate to ask any question. Even if it's out of topic, off topic, or you don't understand something, or you can just post any question. No questions here? So that we can see our first program if you do not have any question here. Okay, I assume no questions here. Alright, so let me just post a question for you guys here, and then I'll post a question if you don't have a question. So you guys had your breakfast for today, or you just woke up? No, you guys don't want to talk to me? Go ahead, answer this question. Yes, answer the question here. Just one more. I hope Numan's busy, he's in the office, so he may not be able to answer this question. Correct answer. So yeah, you're following. I hope you know this already before. Okay, so coming here. Now the next thing I wanna discuss here is the code or the syntax. Okay, let me just call it as syntax. So I told that HTML is all about tags and content, right? So let me just start with the content. Content is text or images. Text or images. So as of now, assume that content is just text or images, okay? So what is the text you write? You write any text, it's called content. And coming to the images, there is a specific specific way to include images in your web pages that I'll be showing later. But yeah, as of now, content is just text or images. Then the next is tags. I talked something about tags, right? So what are tags? So here, let me just first give the syntax of the tags. Tags are always enclosed between, you know, the angle brackets. Okay, so the less than symbol and the greater than symbol on your keyboards. Okay, so all tag names go inside this tag name. Okay, so this is how a tag is written, and tag has certain attributes. So it will be having certain attributes. Okay, so attributes are something like that, attribute name equal to attribute value. Okay, that is it. And sometimes the content goes here and the tag will be closed. So this is a proper structure of a full tag. So such kind of tags, when tags have an opening and closing, so I call this as an opening tag and I call this as a closing tag. You see this, the only difference is the forward slash. Okay, the only difference is the forward slash. So an opening tag, this is an opening tag, right? And that's a closing tag, and this is called paid tag. Okay, this is called paid tag because it has an opening tag and a closing tag. So content here is usually, okay, text. Content here is usually a text. So this particular tag, okay, will have certain formatting, and that formatting is applied on this text, which we'll be seeing very soon. Okay, but this is the general structure of a tag. And sometimes the tags are like this: attribute underscore name equal to attribute underscore value. Okay, you see this forward slash here? It's inside the opening tag itself, and such tags are called unpaid tags. Right? Such tags are called unpaid tags because they don't have a closing tag. The tag itself is an opening tag and itself is a closing tag. Okay? And these attribute name and value are absolutely optional. So they are not mandatory that every tag should have an attribute and value. Okay, so these are optional. So I always write something optional inside these two brackets. So if I write anything in these two brackets, I'll just specify it. If it has some meaning, I'll specify it. If it doesn't have any meaning, that means this is called optional. Okay, so that attribute name and attribute value is absolutely optional. Okay, so that is about the tags, and there are certain tags which are mandatory to write inside a HTML code. So those tags, I'll be specifying it here. Okay, doc type HTML. So this will, okay, so this will tell us, so I'll write inside this. So this means what is the document type and which version of HTML does it use. Okay, actually it's not what is the document type, it is the document which tells. Okay, I'll say it is the document type that tells which version of HTML does it use. Again, coming to the versions, I told you I'm not talking about the history of the HTML here. If you're really interested in knowing the HTML's history, go ahead, and there's a lot of bunch of things on Wikipedia. You can Google it and just check it out. Okay, so now coming to our context here, okay, I said doc type HTML, that means I am using HTML5 version. So this particular piece of web page, this particular web page is using HTML5 type of tags. So that's what it means. Remember, but this is mandatory, without which today's web pages are not really rendering the type of content it has to render. Okay, so So that's why I told there are certain tags which you are supposed to use forever to write your HTML page. So the next set of tag is HTML tag. It's a paid tag. So I always, what I do is for paid tags, I just open them and close them and write content later so that I do not forget to close them. Okay, so this is my practice. My practice is that as soon as you open a tag, close the tag. Okay, so HTML, that means I am writing some HTML content inside this. Okay, then every HTML tag has two children, a head and a body. So I use again the next convention I use here is indentation. Indentation is to say which tag is the parent of which and which tag is a child of which. Okay, so now tell me guys that what are head and body tags to HTML? Okay, head and body tags are the children of HTML tags, hence the indentation, one tab space here. You can see here, this is my programming standard. So I always use standards here to make my coding understand easier and better. Okay, so in here, okay, again head tag has some children here, a title tag. Okay, so here a title goes here. Don't worry about this, we see in a real-time program, we don't have to worry about it. Okay, and here is what actually are all meaningful tags come here and content. So this is a standard structure. Like if you have, you can copy this and put it somewhere so that whenever you want to write a HTML page, you can just copy paste it and start writing your title and the content. That's it. You don't have to write them again and again and again. Alright? Any questions here? Any questions regarding the syntax? Am I going too fast? You can just tell me. I'm sorry, you're really going fast. I can't really understand. Slow down. I can do that too. No issues in that. Yes, guys. Any questions here? So if you don't say any question, I assume that there are no questions here. Yes? Okay. So that's about it. So that's about the syntax. And let's see our first program then. Okay. So let me just take a small break here, a 2-minute break, and I'll be back after the break here. So you guys also can, stretch your muscles, get some coffee, anything. So I'm back, guys. So you're here? Yeah? I hope you are. So yeah, let's just go ahead and see our first program here. Alright, so yeah. So I'm gonna share my screen. Just let me know if you have any problems in looking at my screen. So yeah, this is Notepad++. This is what I'm talking about. So Notepad++, you can download it. You can see it here, Notepad++. It looks like this. Okay, so if you have any problems in installing it or anything, just contact me on the Facebook group, whatever I've told in the previously, that ping me on that Facebook group saying that I have particular problem, or if you feel like you want to have some private questions, let's say I don't want everybody to look at my question, you can always email me at here. So okay, let me just put that in a program too. Why should we waste our this thing? So as I said, there are certain mandatory things in writing your programs here. So here, body. So here is the title. So title is our first HTML web page. Okay, that's the title there. And here I write some content. I don't want to write any tags now. Just let's see how plain content looks like. So as I told you, content is nothing but about text. Okay, so yeah, coming here, if you have any questions, you can email me to this email address. Okay, I'll take time to reply, but I'll definitely reply. But I will definitely reply. Alright, so here I'm saving it here. So let me just save it as learn HTML in 5 days underscore first dot HTML. Okay, the first code is the code for the codes, and the next is first dot HTML is the first program we are seeing. Okay, .html is the extension. Remember, as soon as I save it with .html extension, you can see in Notepad++, all the tags are in blue and text is in black. Okay, you see that? That's the reason I use Notepad++, because it has some very good color coding for the tags. This, and that's really cool. Okay, so, and it also gives me the spell, spell corrections too. So save it. So I have saved this in here in this programs folder. Okay, you can save it on your desktop, no issues in that. You can save your desktop, you can go to desktop, create a folder, okay, and just do it. And to see the output, just double click it. You see that? I'm just zooming it. Ctrl+ is a zoom. Okay, whatever I typed there, the plain text, you can see it here. Right? Any plain text is seen here. Right? So just plain text. Now what I want to do here is, okay, so I want to use, I type this in a new line. You can see that here. I typed that in a new line, but it did not put any new line over there. It's just continuous text, right? There was no break. So how do I put a break? So that is our first tag. This is the first tag you're gonna learn. So the tag which is used to push the content to next line is called br. Br is an unpaid tag. It does not have any closing tag. It's a self-closing tag, and br stands for break. So usually people call it as line break, but br stands for break. You see the angle bracket here, and you see the angle bracket here. Okay, and a forward slash to indicate that it's a self-closing tag. We don't need any closing tag for that. So now I save it again. I come back here to see the output again. I had to refresh it, so I'll just refresh this. Now you can see here the content is pushed to the next line. So br is a break tag which is used to push the content to the next line. Right? Any questions here? Just plain simple, just a plain thing. So now here, now let me just do one thing, one more thing here. Okay, hey, welcome to Tudos Live. I am your tutor for the next 5 days to teach HTML for free. Okay, so let me just go here refresh again. See that again? So what I want to really do here is, okay, what I want to do here, okay, let me just I push something else here. Let me just close that. So yeah, coming here. So here I want to separate these two as paragraphs. You can write paragraphs in HTML and there's a tag for it. Okay, what I want to do here is a paragraph tag. Paragraph tag is called P stands for paragraph. So indentation to show that, you know, this text is inside this paragraph tag. Right? So this tag is a paragraph tag. So let us just go here. I want to refresh. You see that now? It is pushed into the next line. So let me write another paragraph here. We have in today's class 3 students, okay, Numan, Devesh and Rajni, I guess, I hope I'm not wrong. Okay, so I'm writing another paragraph. You can write it like this, or if you want to make it clear and clean, then you can use the indentation here too. Okay, so I'll just refresh again. See again, a new paragraph. So every time I use a P tag, there's a gap you see here and it's pushing in the next line. So this is how you write paragraphs. So not just this paragraph, I'll show you guys, you know, let us just see help contents here. So I just want to copy the entire code here, you know, some dummy text. So here I'll write another paragraph here, pasted it there. There is no indentation because okay, now it's good. Right, so let us just see here. I'll go here and refresh. See that? That's a paragraph. And coming to the title, you guys have seen the title, right? Where is the title text here? You guys may wonder, okay, we have written some text over there in terms of title. So let me just go back to the code here. You see this title? Where is that text? Where is that content? You may wonder, where is that content? Okay, that content is right here. You see? Our first HTML web page. So that's why title is used. You can see on every here, this is Gmail. So it says inbox something, that's the title for it. And this is some Google Drive, so TT Live Google Drive. And this is Net Promoter Score responses. And this has a title, and this has a title, and this has a title. So this has a title too, and this has a title too. So every page has a title, and you're never ever supposed to forget the title of the page. So that's the reason I said it's mandatory. Okay? Yes? I hope I'm clear here. So that's our basic first tags. Okay, so I'll want to talk about one more tag here. Okay, so let me just come back to the class here and stop the sharing here. Okay, remove this break. We're not taking any more breaks, so no enough break. So that's about the first tag we have seen. The first tag is our P tag. Okay, so P tag, we're not using any attributes as of now. And I don't want to use the attributes also. So this is our first tag and there is some text content. Alright? Yes? So the next tag we're talking about is called, there are a group of tags. They're called header tags. So if you want to put something, some heading on the page, let's say, okay, how do you do that? Use header tags for it. We have 6 different types of header tags. Okay, they are H1, H2, H3, H4, H5. So these are 6 different types of heading tags we have. So the only difference between these two tags is only the font size, like how big is the font. That's the only difference. and rest of the things are all the same, except sometimes even the boldness will be less in cases. Maybe that's proportional to the font size. Okay, so these are the six different types of header tags we have, and let's see how they look like on the browser. Okay, so I'm going to share my screen again here. Okay, so let's go ahead here. So here at the top, at the very top, okay, I'll start from h6. Okay, let us start from h6. So h6, I am h6 heading tag, and I'm the youngest of all. So I call it as youngest because it was the last one, right? So hence I call it as youngest. So let's go back here and refresh. You see this? Hey, I'm h6 heading tag, and I'm the youngest of all. Okay, so now let's introduce our the next in the line, h5 tag. So I say, hey there, I'm older than h6. Okay, let's see. See that now? This is the size. Hey there, I'm older than h6, and guess me. Okay, so that means it's a h5 tag. So h5 tag is a tag which is older. Alright, so let's just check another tag here. The next in the line, h4. h4 tag, I am h4. And look at my size. So let us see how big this guy is. Okay, this guy is slightly bigger than the h5, right? This is h5 tag, and this is h6 tag, and this is our h4 guy, right? So let's talk about h3. I'm h3, and nice meeting you. Okay, so let's go ahead here and refresh it again. See, now this guy is a bit bigger than the h4. Okay, so these are mainly used for headings, so you can see, but h6 is not used for headings unless and until there is really a case where you have to use h6 for heading. Even I'll just explain you where I use these tags in particular. Okay, so that use case I'll be giving you guys. Let us just see the different sizes here. So now coming to the h2, okay, h2, I'm way bigger than my anger. I call it as brother, okay? No gender bias here, you can call it as sister too, so, but yeah, I'm calling it as brother, okay? So yeah, you can see it here, the difference between h6 and this is h2. Now you can guess the size of h1, right? So let's see, h1. Hey there, I am h1, biggest of all, and use me only once in one page. Okay, now you guys know when to use which one and why to use it. You can see it here, the bigger guy. I'm h1, biggest of all, and use me only once in one page. So now here, to summarize this, okay, let me just unzoom this or zoom out to the 100% so that you guys will be knowing about this. Okay, this is the regular thing. I'm not zooming there. Okay, I zoomed out everything to the normal size. So now you can see it here. This is used only once in the page, h1. Use it only once if it is really necessary. Okay, and h3 is used for subheadings, like you have a very big heading and you are supposed to use only once in a page, because that's because of SEO, search engine optimization, which is of our that's not our topic. So but yeah, you are supposed to use only one time h1 in one page. So if you have multiple pages in your page, like two doors live, you go here two doors live, so Oh, I'll just show you. This is one page and this is another page. So you can use H1 in the previous one and you can use H1 in this one only once. Okay? You guys following me? Hope. So yeah, that's regarding the header tags. So use H1 and H3, and the rest, it all depends upon the designer's choice. Like, do I have to really go with H6? Okay, and usually H6 looks, you know, way smaller than the actual text here, if you could spot the difference. And H5 is a little better. H4, I don't really suggest, but H3 and H1, that's what I really suggest over there. Yeah, any questions here before I proceed to the next tag? Okay, so now what if I need, okay, let me just do one thing after this this paragraph. So what I do here is, okay, I'll just remove this paragraph there. I'll take this guy, I control X is for copy, sorry, cut. I just cut that, and here I'll use H1. Let me just refresh this. See here, this is the H1 tag. Hey there, welcome to Tutu's Lab. I'm your tutor for the next 5 days to teach HTML for free. Okay, so now I would like to have a line after this particular tag, the H1 tag. Okay, the first tag. So the line tag is HR. HR stands for horizontal rule. It's just similar to the break tag. It's an unpaid tag. There is no pair, and this is a paid tag. You can see it here, a opening tag and a closing tag, an opening tag and a closing tag, opening and closing tag, and whatever the formatting is applied on the text here, right, on the content. But coming to the HR, it's a standalone tag, unpaid. It does not have an opening, closing, both are the same here. So let's just see here. I'll refresh this. You can see here a horizontal line has come up. Okay, so a horizontal line has come up. So any questions here? So I'm gonna stop here for today. So your task for today, okay? So your task for today is to replicate, okay? Your task today is to experiment on header tags, paragraph tag, BR, and HR. Okay, this is your task, and try to use the title tags differently. You know, just do crazy experimentations. There is nothing wrong in it, and there is no issues in that. You can, you know, go ahead and start doing some programming, or I don't call it as programming. Write some markup using these tags, the header tags, P, BR, and HR tags. So any questions here before I leave, so that, you know, I can answer your questions. You can also, yeah, any questions here for today? No questions? Okay, fine. So yeah, this is the live class, guys. So you can also attend the live class if you're interested. For those who are watching the recorded classes, the class happens every day at 11 o'clock at Indian time. And it's completely free for you guys for the next 5 days, so you don't have to pay anything. And yeah, and this class will be available a bit late on the YouTube than the live class, so it's being recorded. You can also find the class files on the website. You have to register to download the files on the website, and for the link to the files, okay, just watch out for the recorded video which comes out. Okay, it will be placed in the front of the video itself and in the description too if you want. Okay, so don't forget to subscribe to us on the YouTube, follow us on G+, and, you know, join the Facebook group for any questions, like our Facebook page for any updates. And for those people who are looking out for jobs, okay, follow our LinkedIn company page. Okay, just search for Tutu's Live on LinkedIn and you'll find our company page, where we'll be posting the job updates over there, you know, in different companies who are affiliates to us. Alright, so, and don't forget to leave a feedback, please, and don't forget to share with your friends. And that's Sagar for you guys. Have a great day today. And I hope I see you again tomorrow. Okay, bye-bye. Take care. Yeah, no problem. Don't forget the feedback, please. Thank you.